Hello student, welcome to this session. I am Vasant Naik from Canara Engineering College. In this session, we will discuss full substructor and how to implement full substructor by using VHDL. So, full substructor is a combinational digital circuit which subtract a three single digit X, Y and borrow in X, Y and borrow in and produce output, that is difference and borrow out. So this is the truth table for full subtractor, that is we have three input A, B and borrow in and difference and borrow out. Now we'll see 0 minus 0, that is first case is here you can see zero minus zero minus zero is zero. Once again, that minus zero is zero, difference is zero and borrow out is zero. In the second case, 0 minus 0 is 0 and 0 minus 1, difference is 1 and there is a borrow. Third case, 0 minus 1, so difference is 1 and borrow is 1. In the fourth case, 0 minus 1 is 1 with the borrow is 1 and 1 minus 1 is 0. Like this we have written the truth table for output and difference and borrow out. Now we will see how to implement this one by using VHDL. Before implementing this one by using VHDL, you have to solve this one by using K-map. So when you solve this one by using K-map, you will get the expression something like this. So this is the expression for difference and borrow. Difference is nothing but this one and borrow is nothing but this one. So this is the expression for difference and borrow. So same code will we are going to write the same code in VHDL. We will see how to execute this one using Xilinx software. So once you install Xilinx software, we are going to take the help of Xilinx software. Once you install Xilinx software, depending on the version, you will get the icon on your desktop. So here you can see the icon. This is the icon. Depending on the version, here I am using the version 9.2 high. Latest versions are available. So when you tap on this icon, it will open Project Navigator. So this is the Project Navigator window. If any project is open, first you will close that project. So on the left top corner, you have option File. Click on the file option. In that sub options, you can see here sub option, first close the project. Next, click on the file option and click on sub option new project. So here it will open new project wizard. Here you have to give the project name. So project name can be anything except some special characters. You can use the special character such as underscore. Other than that, you cannot use the other special characters. So let me give the file name here. Full subtractor, and you can set the directory of the you can set the project directory by navigating this this button. Once you done the necessary changes, click on next. So here you see the information related to the hardware. Our FPGA hardware is a Spartan 3E. So if you click on family, you can see the different options in drop down menu. So our FPGA hardware is a Spartan 3E. Then device, according to the manufacturer, this is a XC250E. Then package is FT256. Then we use the language VHDL. After selecting the necessary changes, then click on next and finish. Here you can see the information related to your project and hardware. Once you click on finish, on doing so, you will get the option here, that is our FPGA chip. So now this chip you are going to program it by using VHDL language. For that you have to right click and you have to add the file by using new source. So here you will get the option. By using the particular option you can program this chip. Here we use the language VHDL, that's why we are using VHDL module. And the file name can be same as the project name also, and same restriction holds good for this also. I'll give the file name full_sub. Then click on next. Click on next button. Then you will see here new source wizard, where we'll mention port name, that is input port and output port. In our case, input port is that is so the inputs are A, comma B, comma actually it is borrow C, then output DIFF difference, comma borrow BORROW borrow. This is output. Click on the output mode and click on next button. On doing so, you will see the code window. Here entity has been created for our FPGA package, this one chip. If you click on that one, you can see, you will see here the so many code has written by the Xilinx software. So here all these are comments. We can delete this one. So this is the library section. So we are using IEEE.standard_logic_1164.all, which contains all the functions necessary to implement our project. So these are the comments not necessary. So now you can see here, you see here, which contains entity declaration and architecture. So in the entity, you see entity followed by full name, entity followed by entity name, that is full subtractor, is, and port declaration is the input port A, B and C of type in and of data type STD logic. STD logic is a part of our library. Similarly, difference and borrow, these are output port followed by output port of type STD_logic. So now entity should end with the end and entity name. Now similarly, architecture name belongs to particular entity, and we have to write the statement between begin and end. So now we'll write the statement. So our code is ready. Entity declaration followed by architecture declaration along with the code. So this is the code for full subtractor, that is difference and borrow. Here you can see difference, sorry, the variable DIFF difference is assigned with the this expression. Similarly, the borrow, variable borrow is assigned with the this expression. That is here difference and borrow both are signal, that is the output port signal. Now we will synthesize our code. Synthesize is the process actually, or synthesize is the tool which will understand our code. First it will check the syntax. So click on synthesize XST. So run, click on the run option. So before running this option, it will ask you to save the code. So click on yes. Now it will take time. It will pop up any semantic errors are there. So if you get a green check mark, that means our code is ready for hardware generation or hardware package generation or hardware circuit generation. The code is ready. There is no error in the semantic error in the code. So now the second step is, the second stage is giving input to the our code. So input to the code can be given by the process called as test bench. For that, once again right click on the our package, and right click on our package, you will see the option new source. Click on new source. Here you will see the option test bench waveform. You can give the input by using in terms of waveform, or you can give the input by means of a input code. There are two options. One is called as a VHDL test bench and test bench waveform. We will use test bench waveform here. So it will, now it asks for the file name. So give the file name. _TB. So you can give any file name. _TB is the protocol we follow here. So to indicate this is a test bench waveform. So click on next. Click on next. So here you can see, here you will get option to set the clock, but our circuit is a combination circuit, it is not a sequential circuit, so we will not select the clock here, we will select a combinational circuit, combinational option. So click on finish. Now here you have to give the input. As I described in my previous video, in full adder session, we will give the input for three variables, that is A, B, C, 000, 001, something like this. The first option is first option is 000, that is A is 0, B is 0, C is 0. Second one is 001. Third option is 010. Fourth option is 011, that is this one. So 000. So let me repeat here. 000, 001, 010, 011. The next option is 100. So the next one is 100. The next one is 101. Here you have to click. At this point you have to click 101. Next one is 110. Next one is 110. And the last one is 111. After that we will reset it once again to 000. So now we have given the input. So you can check it by using the marker also, as I told in the previous video. So now we will test our code. For that, you have to change the option on the left hand side to behavior simulation and go to process. So here you find a Xilinx simulator. So click on simulator behavior model. So right click on simulate behavior model. So when you click on behavior model, it will pop up for saving the code, saving the our input and code. Click on yes button. So here you will see the output. You can cross verify the output by right clicking add marker. So when you use add marker, you see the value of the input variables at that point, that is 001. When it's 001, the difference is 1 and borrow is also 1, that we can verify from our table. So when 001, difference is 1 and borrow is also 1. So like this you can check the other combinations. So this way we can implement full subtract. Thank you.